So far, we talked about pollinators in general terms. In this video, we'll discuss them in a little more detail. The vast majority of pollinators are insects that comprise the largest animal clade, numbering well above a million species. One of the reasons for this huge number is the coevolution insects undergo with plants, resulting in more and more insect species and more flowering plant species. Not all insects pollinate flowers. Many of them, like this locust here, just eat them.
The main groups of insect pollinators are beetles, butterflies, flies, and of course bees. Beetles mainly eat pollen from open plate like flowers. Like these poppy anemones that paint Israel in red in winter. For them, beetles are the main pollinators. Beetles will also eat pollen of any other flower where it's accessible.
Many butterflies have a long proboscis and they feed only on nectar. In flowers that are pollinated by butterflies, the nectar is usually hidden deep in a narrow tube. Butterflies are mainly diurnal and they have excellent color vision. There are butterflies with up to 15 different types of photoreceptors. We humans have only 3 such types.
Flowers that are pollinated by butterflies are often red or pink. Moths are nocturnal, and the flowers they pollinate are usually big, white, and fragrant, like these lilies.
The by far most important group of pollinators are bees and wasps. There are more than 20,000 species of bees, and most of them are in fact solitary. Only a few species are eusocial, like the honeybee. Bees are covered by branched, feathery hairs that collect pollen. Honeybees and bumblebees have special pollen collection baskets called corbicula on their legs. They use their tongue and unique pollen combs to transfer the pollen collected on their body into the corbicula, as you can see here. One mechanism to ensure fidelity is that collecting pollen from each species requires learning, so that it makes sense for each bee to specialize. A further mechanism to ensure fidelity is that pollen, as you see here, have a rather complex and species-specific structure. In order to stick together in the baskets, pollen must be of the same type. Indeed, we can see that each bee carries pollen in a different color from a different flower. Even in the honeycomb, we see that each cell gets a different pollen. From among vertebrates, birds are the major group of pollinators. They are also pollinating bats, but we will not talk about them here. In southern and eastern Africa, we saw many species of sunbirds. Here, in this guidebook of eastern African birds, alone, there are over 50 species. Sunbirds entirely depend on flower nectar. They are therefore restricted to tropical areas where their nectar flowers bloom all year round. In Israel, we have one species, the Palestinian sunbird. A century ago, this bird was restricted to Jericho, where it fed on the flowers of the parasitic Loranthus. In recent decades, more and more gardens were planted all over the country, and sunbirds can be found now all over Israel. For example, the hibiscus in my garden blooms all the time, even in winter, and attracts a large flock of sunbirds. In Central and Southern America, colibris, like these I photographed in Nicaragua, pollinate flowers. Like sunbirds, they are small, colorful, and have a very long beak to drink nectar. They too prefer red flowers. The smallest species weigh just 2 grams. The most pronounced difference is that sunbirds feed while standing on a branch, while colibris feed in flight.